Good afternoon, Hanilyn.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Okay, Hanilyn, can you tell me about yourself?
My name is Hanilyn Panday, 29 years old. I'm a single mother and I have one son. He is 6 years old.
Okay, I have a few questions for you to answer, so let's start.
Yes, ma'am.
Why do you want to work as a maid?
Because it's near, because it's easy to apply and no placement fee.
Why you choose Malaysia when there is a lot of other country?
Because it was near and the culture it have similarity in Philippines.
How are you qualified for this job?
100%.
So you are 100% qualified for this job?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, may I know what your educational level is?
I'm a high school undergrad.
What was your recent working experience?
I was working in a motorcycle shop as a sales lady.
Have you worked abroad before?
Yes, ma'am.
Which country was that?
Kuwait, ma'am.
Okay. Do you have experience of taking care of baby?
Yes, ma'am.
How about elderly?
Yes, ma'am.
And whose elderly are you taking care of?
My mother's boss. My boss mother.
Okay. Do you have any other special skills?
Massage.
Massage, alright. Basic massage, okay. Are you willing to learn new skills?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you willing to work with the family where the mother-in-law or any relatives stay together?
Yes, ma'am.
Currently, are you still working now?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you know how to cook?
Filipino food, ma'am.
Okay. Are you aware that you will have to do washing, cleaning, ironing, and cooking?
Yes, ma'am.
From all the house chores that I mentioned to you, which do you like most?
Cleaning the house.
If ever you were selected to work in Malaysia, who will take care of your kids?
My parents, ma'am.
You are not allowed to use handphone during working hours.
Yes, ma'am.
You are only allowed to use handphone after you finish all the works and when going to bed.
Yes, ma'am.
You are strictly needed to surrender the handphone to your employer in the morning and your employer will return back to you once you're going to bed.
Yes, ma'am.
If ever your employer finds out that you're abusing of using your handphone and it's affected your work performance, your employer will confiscate your handphone and you are not allowed to hold it anymore.
Yes, ma'am.
Instead, your employer will allow you to call to your family 3 times in a month. You only allowed to bring normal phone and you are not allowed to bring smartphone. Are you agreed for the terms and conditions?
No, ma'am.
Okay, if in case your employer or you will overuse the handphone, the employer have the authority to confiscate your phone.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so in short, if ever your employer finds out that you're abusing of using your handphone and it's affected your work performance, I will just repeat, okay? Okay, the employer will confiscate your handphone and you are not allowed to hold it anymore.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, but instead, because of what you do, the employer only will allow you to call to your family 3 times in a month. You only allowed to bring normal phone, okay? And you are not allowed to bring smartphone. Are you agreed with that?
Yes, ma'am.
So, in short, are you agreed to the rules and regulation of the handphone?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you, okay. Can you describe for me your attitude?
Patience. Understanding and respectful.
Okay, how many years is the contract as you agreed and understands?
2 years.
Okay, how can you assure to us that you will work hard in Malaysia?
I work hard due for my contract.
Okay, assure to us that you will finish your 2 years contract.
Yes, ma'am. I will finish my contract.
Okay. Can you promise not to use the telephone without the permission of your employer?
Yes, ma'am, I promise.
Can you promise not to put on makeup but to dress properly while work?
Yes, ma'am, I promise.
Can you promise not to invite friends and relatives without the consent of your employer?
Yes, ma'am, I promise.
Can you promise not to ask for advance salary from your employer under any circumstances?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you really understand of the rules and regulation of the agency?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you pay any placement fee for you to come to Malaysia to work as a maid?
No, ma'am.
Do you have any history of sickness, breast cancer, or any other illness?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Do you suffer from any skin diseases, allergy, or physical defect?
No, ma'am.
Have you suffered from any serious illness again?
No, ma'am.
Do you smoke?
No, ma'am.
Have you undergone any operation?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Are you medically fit or are you fit to work?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you in any medication right now?
No, ma'am.
Are you allergic with any food?
No, ma'am.
Are you preferred to work for the employer of any races?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you preferred to eat the type of food taken or given by your employer?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you preferred to eat again the type of food taken or given by your employer?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Are you afraid of being left alone in the house?
No, ma'am.
Are you afraid of dogs or other pets?
No, ma'am.
Can you promise to work according to instruction from your employer?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you have any family members working in Malaysia?
No, ma'am.
Okay, Hanilyn, we have finished the question section portion. Let's go to case study. I have a case study for you and I want you to answer me truthfully.
Yes, ma'am.
Upon arrival in Malaysia within 6 months only, if ever any of your family members passed away, what will you do?
I will tell from my employer. It's depend on the situation of who passed on my family.
Okay. What about the family members passed away?
If I really need to go back home, I will ask to my employer.
If in case the employer will not allow you, what will you do?
It's okay.
About yourself again, and why do you want to work in Malaysia as domestic helper?
Pardon, ma'am?
Tell us about yourself again, and why do you want to work in Malaysia as domestic helper?
My name is Hanilyn Panday. I'm 29 years old and I'm a single mother. I have son, he's 6 years old. And I want to work to Malaysia because of financial problem. And I choose Malaysia because it's near. Mm-hmm. And the culture is the same here in the Philippines.
Okay. If ever your employer is watching you right now, what do you want to tell them?
Hello, ma'am. Good afternoon. Good day.
Okay, go on.
And I would like to meet you, mm-hmm. and thank you for give me a chance to work in your family, and I do my best to work hard, and I make sure that you will not regret to choose me to work in your family.
Okay, thank you very much, Hanilyn. We will update to your agency if there is any selection made by the employer.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.